Hi, it's Saturday on Out Late But Great, and this is Tracy. And I have dogs barking and an air show going on overhead, so I'll try to get this done without too much distraction. This week, our question comes to us from Mick, and she wants to know, the current wave of politics in the United States heads nearer and nearer to equality every month. If the tide was to turn and governmental powers were to start taking away strides that have been made, how would your day-to-day life change? And would you behave any differently if opposition became stronger? Well, Mick was not too far off when she talked about opposition against the wonderful 15 years of great strides the LGBT community has made. I'd like to share with you some of that opposition. I went through the entire Republican platform for the election coming up this year with Mitt Romney and Paul Ryan as the ticket, and I chose a few sentences out of there to illustrate how our rights may actually go backward if Republicans take office. First of all, I want to give you the title of the Republican platform, and it is We Believe in America. Okay, I'm going to read a little bit of the Republican platform, and it, as I was just telling Karen, it's absolutely preposterous. I mean, I was sort of laughing when I read it, that they talk about, you know, the freedoms and rights and equality, and yet the whole thing is basically, you know, we're going to destroy the EPA, we're going to take away these rights, we're going to make immigrants leave, and it's just a bunch of hate mongering. So I'm going to give you some examples. First of all, in the preamble, they start off with the American dream is a dream of equal opportunity for all. And I guess they need to put parentheses around that and say, unless you're gay. Then it goes on to give a quote by George Washington that basically states that heaven won't smile on a nation which disregards eternal rules of order and right, I guess according to them. And then they go on to say, values matter, period. Character counts. And I think that's just code for if you don't believe like we do, then you have no values or character. The preamble ends, may God continue to shed his grace on the United States of America. Well, there goes that kind of separation of church and state with just the beginning of the platform. So then it has four different sections, and I'm going to read the headline to the section and then a brief outline on what they state in it. I pulled out the stuff that has to do with gay rights. The first one is, we the people, : a restoration of constitutional government. And in it, they have pulled out a paragraph, and it's highlighted, and it states, defending marriage against an activist judiciary. In it, they state, it is an assault on the foundations of society, challenging the institution which for thousands of years in virtually every civilization has been entrusted with the rearing of children and the transmission of cultural values. So basically, because gay people want to have families, we are an assault on the foundations of society. That doesn't sound like a real inclusive big tent kind of party to me. A second paragraph that they have in that section is called A Sacred Contract, Defense of Marriage. And the sentence I pulled out of this states, we reaffirm our support for the constitutional amendment defining marriage as a union of one man and one woman. So they will defend DOMA if they get elected, which means that we will not have as many rights as we should have, and we will not be able to have recognized families by the federal government. And the third thing I pulled out is the First Amendment, the foresight of our founders to protect religious freedom. And in it, they state, we condemn the hate campaigns, threats of violence, and vandalism by proponents of same-sex marriage against advocates of traditional marriage, and call for a federal investigation into attempts to deny religious believers and their civil rights. So basically, I saw this and I was just shaking my head. Well, first of all, like, what threats, what violence, what vandalism? I haven't seen it. I've seen threats, violence, and vandalism against gay people, but I really haven't seen it against these idiot groups. Maybe the guy who wrote some the kind of graffiti on the side of Chick-fil-A was the worst thing I had seen. I have not seen anything like this, and for them to mention it is disgusting, because gay people face persecution in society every day, especially if you live in some backward area, and yet they will not put forth any kind of special laws or treatment for people who, based on sexual orientation, because they're bigoted, yet they claim that they're being persecuted because they're religious. It's such bullshit. All right, second big paragraph that they talk about, it's reforming government to serve people. And in it, once again, they talk about judicial activism, a threat to the U.S. Constitution. And once again, they reiterate, we will fulfill the responsibility to defend all federal laws, including DOMA. This is all mixed in with when they're talking about the Postal Service, immigration, Medicaid, taxes, Social Security, Medicare, and the Internet. And they have to throw in something against gay people and DOMA, even in something having to deal with services that the United States performs. Just shows their commitment to getting to keeping DOMA, defending it, and taking away our rights as citizens, taxpaying citizens of this country. And finally, renewing American values to build healthy families, great schools, and safe neighborhoods. Oh my goodness, Republicans just love everybody. They want us to have safe neighborhoods and good schools. Here's one of the things they talk about in there. First, they talk about preserving and protecting traditional marriage. And it starts, the institution of marriage is the foundation of a civil society. And then it goes on later in the paragraph to state, it has been proven by both experience and endless social science studies that traditional marriage is best for children. And then it says a bunch of other stupid shit having to do with the same misinformation, lies, and bad science, junk science. And then the paragraph ends, we embrace the principles that all Americans should be treated with respect and dignity. I guess, once again, parentheses, unless you're gay. So Mick wants to know how our daily lives are going to change if the Republicans get into office. Well, my daily life isn't going to change. Marriage equality is a wonderful thing. It should happen. It's right. It's American to recognize families, to make families stronger, regardless of what the Republicans say. I've said this numerous times. The day I signed that divorce decree was the day I lost rights. And, I think if the Republicans get in, fine. We're probably going to have quite a few years, maybe 15 years of backward movement. We have so much momentum now, and we need to keep that momentum going. And if we don't, in 15 years, just like 15 years ago to now, we've made such strides. In 15 years, a lot of the baby boomers are going to be, dead. And my son's generation, he's 15, and when he's 30, we will have full marriage equality. I know it, because he is part of the generation that believes that we have a right to exist. So while Romney getting in office is a little bit of a scary prospect, I do think that as long as we keep putting ourselves out there, showing who we are, that we are full of just the same love that for each other that other families have, we will not go back to the days when you couldn't even show your face in public if you were gay. Everyone have a great week. I know this ran long. Take care, and we'll see you next week. Bye.